Hi, I'm Matt and this is Not Enough Tech, and today we're going to cover software section of the $20 build for staircase LED lights. So let's go to the staircase and we're going to talk about PIR sensors a little bit more, shall we? First of all, let's talk about PIR sensors. I've linked a more detailed tutorial about this sensor in particular in the video description below. And we need to make sure that few options are enabled on the hardware itself. You're gonna have two ports in here to adjust timings and just sensitivity. So make sure the timing is kept to minimal. So you want this to trigger as often as possible. And sensitivity, it's gonna be down to your personal situation. In addition to that, you've got a jumper in here, which basically changes the behavior of the sensor itself, whether you can retrigger within this cool time period or not. And obviously you want to retrigger it because we're going to take care of all that behavior within the Arduino code. Lastly, you'll see two pieces of electrical tape. Now, why the tape is here? I've used the tape to kind of modify the range in which the sensors can trigger. So I wanted to see what part, and because I'm gonna print out a 3D part obscuring part of this sensor, so it would only trigger in this narrow area. I obviously don't want staircase to trigger each time I'm walking just within the room. I want to be close to the staircase, indicating that I want to walk downstairs. And once I figure out kind of shape and the shape I'm gonna print out, it's kind of like a, you know, predator eyes, that kind of slit I need for the perfect solution upstairs. Downstairs, the shape is going to be slightly different. And like I said, I just use the tape for now, just kind of get a rough idea of what it's required. That's going to vary in your situation as well. So use some tape or obscure the sensor a bit if you need to figure out your best range and cone shape of the trigger itself. Now, I guess let's talk about the software itself. At first, I had my piece of custom software running and driving the LEDs. But later on, I came across a really nice software from GitHub from Dean Montgomery. And he wrote a really neat code with multiple effects, and there is no reason not to use it because it works really well. Later on, I'm going to modify this code for myself and try to enable Wi-Fi functionality via ESP8266. But as it stands for now, I'm using slightly modified version of Dean's code and works great. And I'm just going to walk you through the steps in the code so you can know what's what and where to modify the values. So this is the Dean's code, and I'm just going to quickly walk through the code with you. So obviously we're using Fast LEDs library to drive the LEDs. And in the definition section of the code, we need to specify some of the variables. There's not all of them that we have to modify, so the most important is number of LEDs. Now, the LED tester, I don't think that works for now, but mine is 2 as well, so I'm quite happy with the effect. The brightness, I kept the brightness to about 150, which gives me the nice bright color without being too blinding at night, so do experiment with that, and the values are, as described, up to 255. And an Arduino pin, and for me, I've modified all the Arduino pins because I drive the sensors and the LEDs on the different pins, so make sure all of those three gets updated. And now down, if you scroll down a little bit, you have off interval, which is 30 seconds, and then long, and this is something I've modified as well because it was a little bit too long. I don't need 30 seconds of cooldown for this. Let's talk about a setup function. This is where we specify the input pins, the output pin, and basically it plays the welcome rainbow animation, and so everything's calibrated and ready to go. Now, in the main loop, basically every X seconds we check what is the value of PIR sensor, and if the value has changed, obviously we're gonna run the update effect function, which will pick an effect at random and display it for our pleasure. So the read sensors function, it's for two sensors, one which is up the stairs and one which is down the stairs here. And basically, if any of them pulls high, we're gonna choose an effect, choose the direction, and basically play our animation. Now, the way the animations are being picked, there is a random seed based on the current milliseconds, and then the value is being picked. And if the value is in a specific bracket, a certain animation in here from the effect function is picked. So you can see that there is an effect function here, and we have a walk, flicker, and fade. Down below, we have a function that basically tells us which direction is up and down. So it puts the LEDs in big array and it orders them either from one to whatever number you've got, or in a reverse order, so it would display LEDs and start to light them up in the correct direction. Below we have another function, which is choose palette. It basically selects one of the palettes available here, and this is to predefine your favorite colors. So the colors aren't assigned from entire RGB palette. It's just a predefined few colors that are available here. This is probably just to avoid getting some ridiculous colors, and it's a very good and neat function. Allows you to trim the colors to your favorite and pick a different palette each time an effect is played. Now, a walk animation means that it's gonna play the effect of individual LEDs lighting up or down with a small delay. So if you look through the core code, you will see this being the case. And lastly, you've got random effect, function mentioned before, when assigning to which effect should be displayed when all LEDs are lit up, and those effects are later on listed as separate functions. So you've got your welcome rainbow, you've got a rainbow with glitter, rainbow again, you've got just to add glitter to current animation, flicker and fade. And I think that's all the effects. Yeah, that's all the effects, and that's pretty much it. So you know now how to modify the code a little bit to suit your needs. You can remove the effects as you go. Just make sure you modify all functions accordingly. And it's much easier to modify the code, I think, than to write one from the scratch. If you check the video description, you'll find additional information, the software code, additional information, written tutorial, etc. Thanks so much for watching, guys. If you're interested in building a staircase yourself, obviously check out my previous tutorial. It'll explain everything step by step to you. Subscribe to my YouTube channel, as currently YouTube makes me work for free, removing all the ads from my videos, unfortunately, and I need at least 10,000 subscribers to apply for the manual review. Annoying. Anyway, I guess we're gonna see you in the next video then. Take care. Bye.